Holiski. Holiski over the 30, and he's pulled down at the 35-yard line. That's where the opening possession of tonight's game. To Vardy. Vardy on the carry.
To run all the way. They had five down.
Bootlegs to the far side. Looks down. The ball away. On the throw. Ryan Felicetti, the receiver. Mike Lucchesi for Butler. To the right. And single setback for Butler. Bootleg keeper up the middle by. Flag goes down. And over the 40-yard line. Finally.
It's an interesting call on third and long. It was designed.
Todd Fritz had a big ball on him.
Having a let up on third down.
Lucchesi is the wideout with the backfield of Horoski Savannah. And that's Holoski. Holoski picks up maybe 2 yards in the front. Looks over the North Hills defense. Man in motion, Holoski. Mullen back to throw. Time to. Erica Stowitz pulls in the ball at the 15-yard line. Double wideout, double slot, single setback is Bob Lewis for North and from the 16-yard line. For Brian Hobbs at the 30, the ball a little overthrown. Indians go immediately to the left, single setback. Now man, Bob Lewis goes in motion to the near side. Delayed handoff, that's Arrington. And gets maybe about a yard loss in the back to the 15-yard line. So that's the Indians go with the wideout, Petrelli to the right, slot man is Hobbs. Now Lewis comes in motion to the near side. A pitch out and the ball is intended for DJ Petrelli, and it looks as though it was just a little too hard thrown.
Passing game.
Brad Morrow back to receive the punt. And the kicker, John Curran, standing 5 yards into his end zone, gets the ball away, time. And the ball is pulled in. On the play by Mike Caringola. Caringola calls for the fair catch.
Like you said, good field position.
Full house in the backfield. First down and 10 from the North Hills 38-yard line. Hand off, that's Vardy on the carry. Vardy pulls his way for 8 yards, and it's going to be held shy of a Butler first down by two.
Three different directions.
Second down, 2 yards to go from the North Hills 30-yard line. McClellan on the handoff again. Vardy on the carry, and Vardy with about 2 yards to spare. Picks up the Butler first down at the North Hills 27-yard line. Line, full house in the backfield, Holoski, Savannah, and Vardy. Hand off on the carry, it's Holoski. Holoski over the 20, he breaks it to the outside, over the 10, 5, and that's where he's knocked out of bounds by Erica Sparowitz for the Indians. 24-yard run by the right halfback, Randy Vardy, 5-11. Looks over the North Hills defense. Man goes in motion, Holoski. And Savannah on the carry gets over the 5 down to about the 3-yard line. So a 2-yard pickup brings up second down, goal, ball on the 3-yard line of the goal, ball on the 3-yard line from the full house backfield. Holoski, Vardy, and Savannah. Man in motion, Holoski. That's the handoff to Holoski. He picks up maybe a yard. He's going to be held shy of a first down, and actually where the official is standing.
Well, it feels a little bit susceptible to that running game, so Butler having their own way right now.
2 feet to go for the touchdown. Holoski in motion, hand off to Holoski, and he is going to be held shy. No sign yet by the officials, and a couple of Butler players do not agree. They are looking at a fourth down and goal.
It looked like Butler almost lost a full yard on that play.
So they're going to go for it. Fourth and goal, ball on the 6-inch line. Man in motion, Vardy. Hand off to Vardy, and he breaks through for the Butler touchdown from six inches, should I say, outside of the goal line.
And attempts to get that 5 yards.
And kicking, Tim Laparulo. Extra point attempt, snap is down, the kick is up. And it's no good. Wide to the left side. So a big break for North Hills.
And in Wells Fargo Hall, they get the competitive edge for this season's Steelers, Panthers, and Whitney Line.
3-1-9-8-7-8, we thank you very much. Kicking off, Laparulo from the 40-yard line, drives it end over end. And the ball is pulled in on the part of Brian Hobbs for North Hills at the 10-yard line. Reverses field over the 20, finds some room, flips and slides down to the 22-yard line. That's where the Indians will start out. First down and 10 from the 22.
Hit
at the 21-yard line of the Indians. Single setback is Bob Lewis. One man is tossed to the left. Sparewitz on the long count. Short drop. Curran pulls it in and through the to the near side. He picks up a good, oh, let's call it 13 yards on the carry.
85 yards on the season. Eric Casparo was just 51 yards away from passing that 1,000-yard mark on the year.
First down and 10 from the 34-yard line of Butler. Bob Lewis in the carry. Hurdles a player, and he's driven back. He gets to the line of scrimmage, and that's all for Bob Lewis.
That's a perfect example over by the Butler offense, and the Butler offense was then able to take over at the North Hills 38.
Curran and Arrington, the two wideouts. Kasperowicz drops back to throw. He's got time. He lets it go. Open. Brian Hobbs a little overthrown, however, as Hobbs was in Butler territory. He would have pulled that ball in at about the 43-yard line. Curley is the wideout to the left. Arrington to the near side of the right. Swat man is Hobbs, and the single setback is Lewis again. Eric drops back this time. Pressure being put on, and the ball is intercepted on the play. And pulling in the ball with the interception, Aaron Sloboda, second time tonight. And I'll tell you what, Kasperowicz had the Golden Tornado 41-yard line, full house backfield. Rich McClellan, man goes in motion. That's Olofsky. And a fake run off to the far side, and that's McClellan tries to string out the North Hills defense. Nothing doing. He's pulled for about a 3-yard loss in the play. Power eye formation for Rich McClellan and company. McClellan drops back, play action. Time to sets up pressure, and the ball's pulled in by Lachetsky. Lachetsky over the 40-45, cuts to the inside, and he gets into North Hills territory all the way down to the 42-yard line. So a first down pickup of 22 yards by Mike Lachetsky for Butler at the North Hills 45. 6-0 in favor of Butler with 1:45 to go in the first quarter. Handoff. And that's Vardy on the carry. Vardy up to the 44-yard line. Actually, on the carry, that's Kolofsky.
Neck, I believe it was.
Second down and 9 for Butler from the North Hills 44. Man in motion, Kolofsky. And the handoff goes to Vardy. Vardy driving his way over the 35-yard line, down to the 33 of the North Hills Indians. So that's a 10-yard pickup by Randy Vardy, and sets the top in the backfield. On the call. And off to the inside on the carry. That is Vardy. Vardy cuts his way inside the 30 to the 26-yard line of the Indians. On the play, Brad Morrow, the wideout, to the left. Whistle blows as the play is developed. And that feels nothing. Again, we'd like to thank the fine folks at the Petros Pizza for providing us with
to go for Butler, driving in North Hills territory. Already on the scoreboard, 6-0, missing the extra point. And they go out of the pro set in the backfield.
Clellan on the handoff, Savannah on the carry, and Savannah over the 25 to the 23-yard line, 4-yard pickup.
Continue to wear them down, the more they're out there on the field pounding it into the line of scrimmage.
I think the North Hills defense got to start thinking about stripping that ball, trying to cause a fumble here.
First down and 10 from the 23. Handoff. Savannah finds some room to the far side. Over the 10, pulled down at the 7-yard line.
That was Kasperowicz who was able to drag him down from behind. North Hills in a goal line defense that time.
So Butler again, first down, goal, ball on the 7-yard line. Full house in the backfield. Rich McClellan on the long count. Late handoff to Vardy. Vardy picks up nothing. He has stopped us the whole night through.
And he's really picked up his aggressiveness tonight.
So about a 2-yard loss in the play brings up second down, goal ball on the 9-yard line out of the power eye. Hand off to Savannah. That time Savannah is stopped. And he picks up maybe 2 on the play back to the original line of scrimmage. 3 yards in that carry. And Savannah now with the Butler Tornadoes had a 3rd and goal ball on the 5-yard line from the power eye to the right. Clellan drops back, looks into the end zone, time strings it out, comes to the far side, pressure, Joe Stern, and the ball in and out of the hands of Savannah.
And guess who broke that up? Todd Fritz, trying to put pressure on McClellan, not the fastest guy out there on the field.
So Butler's going to set up for a field goal here. Looks like it'll be about a 22-yarder.
Liparullo will kick, and it's going to be about a 22-yard attempt. Snap is down, the kick by Liparullo is up. And it's good.
to the right side of that goalpost. Liparillo puts it through, and Butler now with a 9-0 lead.
So there's been a little delay on the handling the snap, but that time the snap was good, handled well, and Liparillo seen by far all year long.
So back to receive, Brian Hobbs, also Mike Garrington for the Indians. Liparillo to kick. It's on the ground as a squibber taken by Wayne Scholar. Scholar can't find the handle. Finally falls on it at the 28-yard line of the Indians. That's where they'll start out. 9:35 to go in the first half of action. North Hills trailing by the score of 9-0.
Losing the battle of field position tonight.
Arrington to the right. Petrelli to the left. Slot man is Brian Hobbs. And the single setback is Lewis. Kasparowicz drops back. Time to throw. Gets it away. The ball in and out of the hands of Arrington, and it's picked off on the play. So the ball is pulled in by Butler. The interception on the play.
Down about the 48. And Eric, maybe tonight being a little too fired up, something you see quarterbacks do when they have the adrenaline going, is throwing just a little overthrowing the ball.
So on the handoff, carry is Vardy. Vardy from the 47 fights his way down to the 43-yard line.
Just throwing a little too far downfield.
Second down, 6 yards to go. The ball on the 43-yard line of North Hills. Power eye formation. McClellan hand off to the up back. That's Savannah. Savannah over the 30, 25, and he's knocked out of bounds close to the 22-yard line. So big play on the carry, and that is Jaron Filofsky to go. Butler on top, 9-0 out of the full house. Tornadoes first down and 10 on the North Hills 22. Driving again. McClellan hand off Savannah on the carry. Savannah breaks over the 15, and he is pulled down at the North Hills 15-yard line. That's where they're going to want.
In rushing in this game, there's still 7:43 left in this second quarter.
Second down, 2 yards to go from the North Hills 15-yard line. Hand off and a nice stop in the play.
Big John Curring stepping in and right at the line of scrimmage, especially in a night where the ball's kind of slick.
Mike Rock is the wideout to the far side. That's the left. Full house in the backfield. Rich McClellan and his Butler Tornadoes from the 14. Hand off Savannah. Looks like he's going to be held short.
Jason Kelly again, the area that they've been picking up.
So the Indians to punt. John Curran stands back at his 10. And back to receive the punt, Brad Morrow, and he sets up at his 45. Curran gets a lot of time to get that ball away. Not a rather high one, but Morrow pulls it in at the 44-yard line, and he drives into North Hills territory, pulled by down by Tim Smith at the North Hills 48-yard line. So that's where Butler will take over, first down and 10.
Points is pretty tough to come back from on this defense, but it's certainly to get another touchdown, but it's imperative to keep them off the board now.
Once again, Butler with outstanding field position.
First down and 10 from the North Hills 48-yard line. Power eye, hand off Savannah. Savannah finds some room over the 45 down to the 43-yard line. Another thing we haven't seen is North Hills special teams. They've been so successful on the run backs tonight.
Running right over the left guard, Jason Kelly, and they're milking for all they can get.
Second down, 5 yards to go from the North Hills 44. McClellan with the handoff on the carry, and that is Vardy. Vardy picks up maybe a yard on the play down to the North Hills 42-yard line. The third down, 3 yards to go. Tornadoes from the North Hills 41-yard line set up, power eye. McClellan looks over the North Hills defense, takes a snap, drops back to throw, lets it go down the far sideline. Rock the intended receiver, and it's batted away. By the very last minute, that's Tim Smith there again. Fields is thrown at them tonight. The running game non-existent. As a matter of fact, Rick, you said negative in yardage tonight. And Eric Kasparowicz is going to be back to receive the punt.
Now, Butler takes a timeout now. This might be one last-ditch opportunity to get something working in the first half.
Well, we'd like to thank, again, the fine sponsors for... So, back to punt. For Butler, and he's going to be standing at his 48. Big punt. It's going to be a big punt. McClellan throws. And on the throw, on the fake, was to Jaron Filofsky. Filofsky down to about the 30-yard line.
Well, they used up a lot of time running in the line of scrimmage and looked like they were going to let the clock pretty much roll out. And now they go out of
in my opinion, to get back in his football game and get some confidence, really. They've had the confidence sucked right out of him here in the first half.
Mike Rock is the wideout. He is to the left side from the I formation. McClellan, play action, looks downfield, goes long, and the intended receiver, Holofsky, was open, but the pass a little overthrown as Holofsky crossed the North Hills 15-yard line.
Had a few plays here.
Wing to the right, throw set in the backfield, second down and 10 from the North Hills 30. Again, McClellan drops the throw. Time gets the ball away. Lachesky's there, and some good coverage on the part of Kent Boland, and backing him up was the quarterback, Eric Asparowitz, for North Hills.
Hey, North Hills just trying to get off the field right now without any more damage.
So we have a third down and 10. Butler on the North Hills 30. Single set back at Savannah. Double wideout slot man to the near side. McClellan goes, and the ball is intended on the play by Mike Cariola. Cariola tried to pull in the ball to seven, in and out of... So we have a fourth down, 10 yards to go. Butler with 17 seconds to go in the half. McClellan again drops in the pocket, gets the ball away, lops it. The wing and a prayer pulled in for the Butler touchdown. And a flag goes down in the play, and it's going to be waved off.
Flag goes down, and that might be offensive pass interference, although it looked like there was contact.
Fine, right at that corner pylon.
So North Hills gets the ball back with 10 seconds left. What do you do?
To the near left side, the right side, they go with the wide out Petrelli. Sparewood sets up first down and 10. Ball on the 45-yard line of Butler. 10 seconds to go in the game. Sparewood drops back, scrambles up over the 50, 45, knocked out of bounds at the 40-yard line of Butler. So you got 3 seconds to go. Now you go for that Hail Mary.
It's a play from scrimmage for North Hills this evening, so it worked.
3 seconds to go. The last play of the first half. Kasparowicz drops back, time to throw, gets it away. The intended receiver was Arrington. The ball is picked off up to the 30, 35, 40, 45, and 50. That's Aaron Sloboda, who picked that ball off at the North Hills 20-yard line and returned it, and he's finally stopped. So the first half ends with Butler on top, 16-0.
Kasparowicz was the one that made that tackle to 50, and actually there was plenty of open room and the possibility of really rubbing that in. The one thing, Rick, that I saw as a negative of throwing the ball up is as far as Eric Kasparowicz's confidence, the possibility of throwing a third interception. That's going to be pretty...
Vardy, hand off.
Allegheny should have beat Butler up this year up at Butler. They were winning that game 20-6, and Butler got a couple breaks in the form of the North Allegheny snapper, long snapper, snapping the ball over the punter's head twice in the fourth quarter and pretty much handing Butler the football game. So no easy task for North Hills next week, but let's not give up on this football game here.
Oh, no, we can't. Actually, going back to what we were talking about, the point difference, it comes down to a tiebreaker for second. Even if they can beat NA next week, I don't think they'll have enough to
see it as wound up. Liberullo to kick off for the Butler Tornadoes from the 40. Back to receive on a squibber. And Arrington lets it go. He picks it up. And now Brian Fiola pulls it in. And Chris Fiola, up to about the 30-yard line. That's where they're going to mark the ball. So the Indians first down and 10. 10, opening possession of the second half of action, trailing Butler by the score of 16-0. Double wideout, slot man, which is Hobbs, to the far side, that's the right side, single setback, hand off to the carry, Bob Lewis. Lewis breaks over the 30 to the 34. 4-yard pickup by Bob Lewis, so the Indians start off with the run here.
of a Penn State type team. Just a lot of big kids, big, strong, strapping youngsters.
Down 7 not ago. The Indians from their own 34-yard line. Kasperowicz drops back to throw. Goes over the middle. Curran pulls it in the flat. He's up to the 45-yard line. So a first down pickup. Big John Curran. First catch tonight for the Indians.
10 plays.
Eric did a nice job of waiting for Curran to get open on that play. He had to wait a couple extra seconds, but he waited and got the pass completed.
First down and 10 from their own 45-yard line. The Indians send Hobbs in motion. Hand off. That's Lewis. Find some room, hurdles into Butler territory at the 48-yard line, 6-yard pickup for Big Bob Lewis.
That's with it, and we have two good running backs, so, you know, let's use it, because if you go with all pass, it's going to come back to haunt you.
The Indians mixing up their plays rather well here to begin the second half. Hobbs in motion, first down and 10 from the Butler 49. Kasperowicz drops back, pumps once, goes long. Hobbs pulls it in at the 30, and he's down at the 29-yard line of Butler.
That's the pass they went on before that.
So the Indians first down and 10 at the 30-yard line of the Butler Tornadoes, penetrating their deepest time tonight. Man in motion, that's Lewis. Now he reverses field. Roll out, bootleg carry. That's Kasperowicz over the 25, down to the 20, breaks the tackle to the 15, and he's finally pulled down at the 14-yard line of the Tornadoes.
Kasperowicz running like a man possessed, 16 yards there. And
so they've driven the ball now 55 yards down into Butler territory.
Arrington and Petrilli, the wideout, slot man is Hobbs to the far side. That's the right side. Single setback, Bob Lewis. Kasperowicz from the 15-yard line. Drops back to throw, scrambles, look, Petrilli pulls it in, down at the 3-yard line. DJ Petrilli wide open, pulls in the ball, North Hills first possession, take it all the way down to the 3, now putting it in, it's going to be the key. First down, goal, ball on the 2. The Indians from the wishbone formation, first time tonight. Set up shot, Kasperowicz, hand off Arrington. Arrington busts through, he goes in for the North Hills score.
Wow.
Mike Arrington, off tackle, goes in, North Hills gets a 6 point. Ken Bolin's the reserve quarterback, holding on the point after. Snap is down, they're going to go for it. Socha on the kick, he splits the upright. North Hills on the board. 8:03 to go in the third quarter, 16-7. We'll be back on 73 WPIT.
Bruder clip.
Oh, my goodness.
As well they should.
Jared Socha kicking off, back to receive, and pulling the ball in is Vardy. Vardy actually lets the ball go to his far side, to the near side of the field. And
it did go out of the, they're calling it illegal procedure.
On extra points on the season. Excellent extra point kicker this
Mr.
season.
Mr. Perfect. And they
Mr.
might need
perfect.
A field goal to win this game tonight, being down by 9 right now.
Socha to kick from the 45, low, end over end. And Vardy touches it. It fumbles away from him. Now it's picked up. Savannah on the carry. Savannah back to the 19-yard line. So it bobbled a little bit. On the return, Savannah finally pulls
two drives in North Hills territory.
Caringola is the wideout to the near side. Full house, man in motion. That's Holoski. McClellan drops back, scrambles to the near side. Bootleg rollout over the 20 and knocked out of bounds at the 23-yard line. 4-yard pickup by the quarterback, Rich McClellan.
McClellan took a hard roll as he was
Full house in the backfield. Caringola out to the right. Vardy in motion to the far side. McClellan drops back. Rolls to the far side, and coming up to play, Bob Lewis. Oh, Bob Lewis pulls down the quarterback for a loss. Oh, and there's a fumble. North Hills recovers. Oh, Bob Lewis comes up, makes the big head on the quarterback, McClellan. And Petrilli, slot man is off to the near sideline. Single setback, that's Lewis. Kasperowicz called. Drops back, long drop, time to throw. Scrambles, gets the ball away, and it's knocked. Batted at the line of scrimmage, and the intended receiver was Petrilli. Double wide out, slot, single setback for the Indians. Man in motion to the far side, that's Hobbs. Hobbs, fake, play action. And Lewis pulls in the ball down at the 16-yard line of the Butler Tornadoes. So it's going to be shy of a first down by about 5 yards.
I thought that was Yates, Alex.
Okay,
it was a nice choice.
The Indians go with the pro backfield. Now they wide out those two pro sets. Double wide receiver, handoff to the middle. That's Arrington. Bounces to the outside. Over the 15, knocked down at the 11-yard line. 6-yard pickup by Mike Arrington.
This whole team is just playing with us.
An awesome second half to win the football game. Are we going to see the same thing tonight?
Well, the Tornadoes are reeling. First down and 10 for North Hills from the 12-yard line. Double wide out, single setback. Kasperowicz drops. Boom!
bootlegs up to the inside, over the 5 minutes to the end zone. Eric Kasperwitz scrambles for an 11-yard run.
I've never seen a team turn around.
The 13, extra point attempt, Jared Socha. Snap is down, kick by Socha is up and good. North Hills makes this a game, 16-14, 5:30 to go in the third quarter of action. We'll take a timeout and be back on 73.
Curry was thinking.
Good point, you don't play for the time.
Just think how this boosts the confidence of this North Hills team. Socha on the kick, and it's going to be very close to going out of bounds. Barty picks it up, he elects the run. Brian Felicetti, oh, also John Miller comes in. Nice play, John Miller, Brian Felicetti. Brings Barty down at the 19-yard line.
Boy, this is...
Gary Ola is the wideout to the
especially
near sideline. That's the right. Man in motion. That's Olofsky. Rich McClellan at quarterback. Hand off Savannah. And he has nowhere to go.
And guess which way he ran? Right at Todd Fritz.
We've only given up 55 points so far this season. Full house in the backfield. Second down and 10 for Butler from their own 20-yard line. McClellan at quarterback. Barty in motion. Play action. Oh, here he comes, the big man into the sack, all the way back to the 5-yard line for North Hills, Chris Berry.
Chris Berry was not going to be denied. He could think a touch on the way to bring
21 yards to go. But a bus ride. Third down and a bus ride. Double wide out. That's Cariola. Also Lucheski back to throw. McClellan airs it out. And the ball is intended for Cariola in. Ken Boland. On the coverage, Bullen's right there, sticking like a fly to flypaper. Fourth down, 22. So the punt by the quarterback, McClellan. Back to receive, Arrington and Hobbs. McClellan gets away. Oh, it's a nice one. It's going to take Hobbs back to midfield. Hobbs lets the ball go, and Butler's going to down it at their own 49. So the Indians now have a great opportunity to go ahead in the game.
Heard a lot of good things the second time in Butler territory at the Butler 49.
So here we go. First down and 10. North Hills on the Butler 49. Single setback. Wide on a slot man to the far side. Kasperwitz drops back. Goes over the middle. Almost picked off in the play. Butler's Brian Minto comes.
Surprised by that pass.
Second down and 10 now from the 49-yard line for North Hills. Hobbs in motion, sets up behind the fullback. Kasperwitz bootlegs. He's going to dump it up. Lewis pulls it in at the 40. Travels, turns. He's out of the 30. 20, 10. Bob Lewis in for the North Hills score. 49-yard run. Oh, we got a new game.
What an incredible run. Sheared it up.
What an unbelievable comeback.
I'll tell you what, Butler couldn't be more shocked if an H-bomb had fallen on them. 20 points. Going for 21 by the North Hills Indians. Kick up by Socha. And it's good. North Hills on top, 21-16. Three up. And I'll take the one in the second half. Thank you. And now to maintain the momentum is the key here. Jared Socha to kick off. Butler not put in this position many times this year. From the 10, Pulaski. Over the 25, 30, breaks it. Holofsky over the 40, down to the 42-yard line. Jaron Holofsky brings back a nice run for Butler and gives them decent field position. Cariola is the wideout to the far sideline. Full house in the backfield for McClellan and the Tornadoes. Holofsky in motion. Hand off. That is Holofsky on the carry. Holofsky gets maybe a yard, if even that. And this North Hills defense is fired up. The ball on their own 43-yard line. 2:06 to go. North Hills on top, 21-16. Kowalski in motion to the near side. McClellan back to throw. Lets it go, and the ball's pulled in by Kowalski at the 50-yard line, and he's going to be about maybe 6 inches. They're giving him a good mark on that play, so it may be close enough for the first down.
First down's in the first half. It was 11-2, and now it's 11-10. So North Hills turning this game around.
Third down and one. Full house backfield. Hand off. Oh, it's a fumble. Pulls in the ball. Eric Kasperwitz at the 50-yard line. North Hills has turned this game around. Eric Kasperwitz. 10. The ball on the Butler 47-yard line. Single setback. Double wide out. Lots to the near side. Kasperwitz looks over the Butler defense. Long count. Drops back, short drop, goes over the middle. Curran, the intended receiver. That ball was tipped at the line of scrimmage, and I'll tell you what, it was intended for Curran, but
101 yards in passing in the second half, and of course that touchdown and a touchdown run and a fumble recovery.
Second down and 10 now from the 47-yard line of Butler. Hobbs in motion to the far side. Kasperowicz drops back. Gets the ball away, airs it out. Petrelli, the intended receiver, and it's picked off out of bounds, though, however, on the play, and pulling in that ball for Butler. Wide out, Darrington to the far side, Petrelli to the near side. Hobbs is the slot man, and the single sent back is Lewis. Third down and 10, Hobbs in motion to the far side. Kasperowicz drops back. He's got time to throw. Gets the ball away. Lewis pulls it in at the 45, 40. 35 down for a North Hills first down at the 34-yard line with a 14-yard pickup.
Bob Lewis, talk about a guy taking charge. You just got a feeling where
Butler 35-yard line, 32 seconds, and clock is ticking in the third quarter. Man in motion to the near side. That's Brian Hobbs. Kasperowicz drops back, hand off to Lewis, finds some room off tackle. Over the 30, he keeps those legs pumping up to the 30-yard line, so a 3-yard pickup by Bob Lewis.
Yeah, we're not seeing...
Butler, you got him on the ropes. You got to keep bringing it to him.
Exactly, Al. A chance to score on your fourth. Right, they're not designed to play catch-up football.
So the Indians second down and 7. Wide out to the near side. Man in motion, Hobbs to the far side. Motion on the part of the defensive line of Butler, and that should go against Butler.
And indeed, it is an offside. This is the second time Eric Kasperowicz has been able to...
On the 25-yard line of the Butler Golden Tornadoes. Kasperowicz with the single setback is Bob Lewis. Man in motion, Arrington, from his slot position to the far side. Kasperowicz rolls out. Rolls out. He's got a little bit... Oh, nice stiff arm. Over the 20, and a flag goes down.
Now, the flag goes down right at the stiff arm, and he might actually grab a face mask. It was pretty effective. Still have to wait and see what the penalty's about. Face masking the other way.
Yeah, Eric put that stiff arm.
So the Indians now, first down and goal, ball on the 9-yard line. They go with double wide out. Slot man is Arrington. Single setback, Lewis. Hand off to Lewis, finds some room. Wiggles and squirms up to about the 7. So it's a 2-yard pickup by Bob Lewis. So I was wrong about the squiggling and squirming. Second down and 9, so he picks up no yards. The Indians go with the trips out to the far side. Arrington, the lone man to the left. Kasperowicz rolls out, pressure being put on, goes into the end zone. Petrelli is there, in and out of his arm. He was to the far sideline.
Throwing some rather questionable passes this evening.
Yeah.
So the Indians go with the trip receivers to the far sideline. Single setback is Arrington. Third and goal, ball on the 9-yard line. Kasperowicz drops back, time to throw, gets it away. Arrington pulls it in, bobbles, he pulls it in, goes into the end zone for the North Hills score. Oh my, I don't know how he held on to that ball.
Arrington wide open, he made it look tough though. He bobbled it at the 8th
in and was able to just get inside the pylon for the touchdown.
So the extra point attempt. Jared Socia, snap is down, the kick is up. Oh, it's good. Man, what a game tonight.
Sports U.S.
Game on you, as Mike Lang would say, for 3 weeks. We've had a great game tonight. North Hills on top, 28-16, 10:35 to go in the contest.
Hard to believe there's still 10:35
left, really.
With as much excitement we've seen in the second half here.
North Hills has put 28 points on the board in just 13 and a half minutes.
Jared Socia kicking a squibber. The ball is pulled on in the play at the 30. And up over the far side to about the 35-yard line for the Tornadoes is Chris Mara.
So Butler in good position to come out. And, you know, down by 10:35, they have to score 2 touchdowns now because they're down by 12. Possession. It's going to have to be more of a pass, time-conserving kind of offense.
So the Tornadoes, first down and 10, the ball on their own 39-yard line, single setback. McClellan goes out to throw, and it's well overthrown. Felicetti there on the coverage.
Over the field tonight.
This is the best football game I've ever seen him play.
Undoubtedly. He's reaching his potential tonight.
Second down and 10 now for Butler from their own 39-yard line. Power eye, McClellan, play action, looks downfield, pressure being put on. Lewis bams into him, knocks him down, no catch in the play. I'll tell you what, Lewis looked like a torpedo.
Really. Fritz has been playing tough all night, not just the
really
second
has.
Half. The whole first half he was playing excellent defensively.
So the Indians have Butler with a third down and 10. Butler on their own 39-yard line. Wing to the far sideline. Wide out to the left. Drops back to McClellan. He goes long, he lobs it up. And almost picked off in the play for North Hills. And let's see who almost... So McClellan will punt on fourth down from their own 39-yard line. Of course, we know McClellan is quarterback, so anything could happen here. Snap back. No, McClellan's going to punt. He gets it away high. Hobbs calls for the fair catch and pulls it down at the 20. So North Hills, really, what can you say about this second half of action?
They're going to have limited time to work with, you know, 8 minutes or 7 minutes to score.
What?
We were talking halftime. Me and Mark Maddie's like, oh, this game, so was I. I was thinking, man, this game is just about history. First down and 10 for North Hills. To Bearwitz. Reverse handoff to Lewis. Lewis tries to find room, and he gets back after losing maybe a yard. Shame on you, pal. I admit it.
Straight upfield. Lewis lining up as a wideout this time. I won't be surprised if they throw deep to him with the way he's playing.
So the Indians go with the trip receivers to the far sideline. Second down, 11 yards to go from the 20-yard line. Desperowitz on a long count. Scrambles out to the far to the near side, and he's going to be hit for about a 7-yard loss, 6-yard loss back to the 13-yard line. 10 yards to go for North Hill. And don't really expect to see Desperowitz take much of a chance on this play.
No, I won't be surprised. They're not sitting back at all. Penalty flag goes down.
It's a layup game against North Hills. That's going to take the ball back another 5 yards. Coming the clock, 9 minutes. But with Butler's type of offense they run, that really eats up the clock. So third down, 23 yards to go. Desperowitz drops back from his end zone. Gets the ball away to Arrington. Arrington makes a few moves up over the 10. To the 12-yard line, and Martin Manning just passed me a note. He said, why did Butler come out throwing the ball after dominating so much in the first half?
9 men on the line of scrimmage for most punts tonight. They haven't really gone after any, but here again right now, they have 9 men up on the line of scrimmage. Expect them to go for the block.
So John Curran punting in his own end zone about 3 yards. Takes his time. He's got plenty of time. Gets that ball away. Morrow pulls it in for Butler at the North Hills 45. Finds some room over the 40. Down to the 35. And finally, off his feet at the 34-yard line. So Butler now has some great field position to try to get things going on their end.
You want to keep that clock ticking, and unfortunately they were unable to do that. John Curran got off a 33-yard punt, and there was an 11-yard return on that. And
timeout, so they still have 3 to work with.
So the Tornadoes first down and 10 at the North Hills 34-yard line. Full house in the backfield. Wide out is Majeski to the right. Olonsky in motion to the near side. They pitch out with an option. That's Rock. Rock looks downfield, double pass, and the ball is picked off by North Hills. Therefore, the North Hills Indians, Ken Boland, picks that ball in, and another big play. And now first down and 10 on their own 1 yard line. So they go with the double wideout slot to the far side. Kasperowicz keeps it up through the middle. Quarterback keep. He gets up to a pop. The 4 yard line, so a 3 yard pickup by Eric Kasperowicz.
For using your timeouts.
Yeah,
right
true.
Now.
Second down, 6 yards to go for North Hills. 4 yard pickup by Kasperowicz. Double wide out, slot man to the far side. An option throw lateral. Pulled in Arrington. He's got a lot of room and immediately in on the tackle as Arrington gets up to the 14 and picks up a first down. Mike Lachesky for the Butler Tornadoes, and Arrington is
11th first down of the second half. Butler 0, first down.
You must stay mistake-free here. First down and 10, ball on the 14-yard line. North Hills hand off it, and that is Bob Lewis. Lewis digs a tunnel over the 15 down to the 16. So keeping the ball out of Butler's hand at this point, at least.
Back for Eric Kasperowicz, the 1 game against Shaler. See him in an offensive way here for North Hills.
Maybe a reward for picking off that pass. Second down and 7 now. Play action, Kasperowicz rolls out, and he barely gets away. As a matter of fact, he is dropped on the play by Butler's big Jason Kelly. Comes in and puts the pressure on Eric Kasperowicz.
They had a short route and a long route there. The long route was going to Curran, and the short one.
Maybe forget the pass and just keep that clock ticking. 4:51 left, 28-16 North Hills.
So the Indians third down and 10 from their 14. Kasperowicz drops back, play action, looks downfield, gets it away. And the ball is almost picked off. John Curran, Lachesky was there. He almost pulled that ball in, tip off Bob Lewis's hand.
Yep. He passes the ball and makes me look like an idiot. So just
shut up. Mark Madden pointed out that Jack McCurry really knows how to play with the lead. He's showing tonight. He is pushing all the right buttons of this team. Fourth down and 10. Back to punt. John Curran standing at his goal line, and flags go down.
Looks like
Butler's never had to catch up this year.
Looks like it's going to be too much time. But you're right. You know, certain offenses are just designed to dominate right from the first quarter.
And they got back in that football game, as I also mentioned, was the North Hills long snapper snapped the ball over the punter's head twice to set up Butler touchdowns in both cases.
Certainly too early to take it easy, because here Curran's punting from his own end zone again.
About 3 yards back, Big John Curran gets the snap, gets it away, end over end. Carrangola pulls in the ball, and they're going to mark it down. I think he originally called for a fair catch, then he decided to run, but the official right on top of the play threw down the marker. So the Golden Tornadoes, first down and 10, ball at the North Hills 31-yard line, trailing 28-16. Drawing eye formation. McClellan drops back, play action, looks downfield, airs it out, all alone, wide open. Barty fumbles the ball, now he pulls it in, he goes in for the Butler score. So Butler comes right back on one play, still a lot of time in this football game with 4:26.
Barley, totally unprotected on the unguarded on that route. He was just ran a fly pattern on the sideline. It was a broken coverage because nobody was even near Barty. So just like that, without taking any ticks off the clock, Butler is 6 points away from this.
So the point after, snap is down, the kick up by Liberolo, and it goes through. So we have a 28-23 game. North Hills on top with 4:26 to go. And get the oxygen out.
Carolina, he's expecting an onside kick, and even his deep man, Arrington, is up at his own 30. So if they kick us one deep, North Hills could be in trouble, but they got all kind of people in the line of scrimmage. Now Arrington dropping back to about the 20.
Same with Hobbs. So Liberolo does kick it back. Hobbs takes it on the run from the 16 over the 25-30. Breaks to the outside, has some room over the 35, and he's knocked out of bounds at the 37-yard line. So the Northfield's in the end.
They're set up back at their 25-yard line and 4:18 left. And Northfield needs a breath of life here as that 12-point
line. So the Indians send the trip receivers to the near side. The single setback is Bob Lewis. And now
timeout is called as the chains weren't adjusted yet. They had to move them down. Now they're set up.
The first down on the ground here, you're going to take at least 2 minutes off this clock, or at least make Butler spend some time out.
First down and 10 from the 24-yard line, and now as the play starts, whistles are blown, and the action is stopped.
Hard to tell what happened there. I doubt it was delayed a game. It would seem to be a dead ball foul, though. Actually, no penalties were thrown.
It looks like it's an official's timeout, and the officials are...
Centers include Lasagna, Linguini, Manicani, Stuffed Shells, Fettuccine Alfredo, also 6 foot hoagies. Give him a call tonight for the best pizza.
I think that kind of takes a little momentum emotionally out of Butler. Yeah. Coming out with that big touchdown, they want to keep it rolling, and they've just been out there on the field kind of...
Receivers to the right side. Single setback is Bob Lewis. Kasparowicz, long count, drops back, hand off. Lewis finds some room over the 30. Breaks to the outside, stays on his feet across the 33, and that's going to keep
on bounds.
So second and two, the Indians now send the trips to the opposite side. Single setback from the 32. Hand off again, Lewis. He breaks it over the 35, picks up the North Hills first down.
I don't know if mouth now with approaching under 3 minutes left in the game.
Trip receivers to the near side. First down and 10 for North Hills from the 35. Kasparowicz again, hand off up the middle, and that's Lewis on the carry for 2 yards. So the plan is simple. Keep it on the ground and run this clock out.
First signaling a Butler timeout.
Yeah, with 3:01 left on the clock. And that's good also, Rick. Even if, you know, keeping the ball on the ground doesn't gain you 30 seconds if you make them use up timeouts, that's just as effective.
It'd be something they have to do unless North Hills can run this clock out.
So the Indians go with their trip to the far side. That's the left side single setback. Second down and 8. Kasparowicz from the 37. Hand off tackle. That's Bob Lewis in the carry, and Lewis picks up about maybe a half yard or so.
I don't keep that clock from rolling. It's down to 250 now. But, you know, Lewis has been such the go-to guy in the second half. He really took charge on offense and defense. And one guy that's going to hang on the ball in this situation is going to be Bob.
You know what, guys? You know one thing we didn't do tonight?
Give away chicken.
Oh, it's a computer. It's not a mind.
Either that or one of those idiot savants. I don't know.
We're lucky. I don't know, but it's...
So the Indians now have a third down and 7. Double wideout, single setback. From the 38-yard line of the Tornadoes. Kasparowicz drops back, play action. Looks to the far side. Oh, pressure being put on. He gets away. Looks downfield. He's going to take off with the ball. And Kasparowicz maybe loses 3 yards after all the running around is over.
You know, you talk about a smart quarterback there, though, because Ferrowitz was under all kind of pressure, had all kind of people traveling on him as Butler uses their third and final timeout, had all kind of pressure, people really dogging him. He had the presence of mind to stop, lower his head, and turn upfield and not go out of bounds in the term tonight. In several situations, he's punted in the North Hills end zone twice, and they haven't gone after the ball. I think they've been happy to just field the short punts and take the good field position they've been getting.
Safe to say this is the biggest punt of John Curran's career, first-year punter for the Indians.
So Curran's going to set up at his 20, back to receive. Caringola, and we await the snap. Curran, time to get it away. Does, and it's a high one, but not very far. And it's called for a fair catch on the play by Caringola. I was looking at Rick's fingers up. I'm like, wait a minute, this doesn't sound right.
So lots of room. I mean, by time, scramble, and he does have an arm.
So here's the game. No timeouts on the part of Butler. First down and 10, power eye formation on their own 41-yard line. Drop back McClellan. Pressure, rolls out. Now he cuts upfield. John Brazen there. Oh, McClellan's got room. Missed by Curran, all the way down. Only guy there is Tim Smith, pulls him down at the 2-yard line.
I don't believe it. We just talked about McClellan has all kind of foot speed, and he just takes off and almost goes 58 yards, 55, enough to get inside the North Hills 5-yard line. What athletic ability.
So Rich McClellan, what a run, all the way down to the North Hills 2.5-yard line. First and goal for Butler.
Two in this football game.
Power, backfield, full house. McClellan takes his time. Man in motion, Horoski. Hands off to Horoski, and he's going to power his way. Hands up by the Butler players. No sign yet by the officials.
Got maybe a yard, and you have to start thinking about using your timeouts if you're Jack McCurry. You give up a touchdown, you want to have time to get back in this game. Now they use it, but they lost about 7 seconds by the time it got called. And, you know, if you're Butler, you want to run it into the gun. Actually, in first down, you're best off not scoring there. You know, with they take two plays to get this one off, because Ferris will have the ball in a minute and, you know, one or maybe two timeouts.
I'd like to see the North Hills defense trying to strip that ball, punching it. What a game.
Full house in the backfield for McClellan and company. Butler from the half-foot line. Horoski in motion. Hand off to Horoski. He pummels over the end zone. Goes in for the Butler score. Jaron Horoski puts the Butler Tornadoes on top, 29-28. And boy, you're going to need a miracle finish, and Jared Socia has to have butterflies in his stomach.
And now you would expect Butler to go for 2 points here. They will probably want to get on top in this game by three.
Yeah, you're right, and Socia's got the ability to kick 40-yard field goals. We've seen him try four this year, never made one, but he's got the leg, and he's showed that. He did make one 40-yard?
It wasn't a 40-yard. I think it was about a 25, 30-yarder, but yeah, I think he's like one for four.
Well, they're going to go for the two out of the power formation. Two-point conversion attempt by Butler. McClellan drops back, bootlegs to the near side, looks in the end zone, fires, and the ball is pulled in for the 2 points.
Now, Minow came in for that catch. You know, the guy we normally see on defense on very little on offense, but now he comes in to come up with that crucial two-pointer. So North Hills, with a field goal, all they can do is tie. 38-21, what a game. Just
a
change of emotions one way or the other. And the way Butler has been able to crawl back into this game in the second half, I wouldn't say crawl, it was just leap back into it. They're not a big play offense. They had the
time needed by the Butler offense to get back in the lead of this football game.
So Mike Arrington will be called upon unless they do not kick to him. And if you're a Liberolo, I don't see why you would. Squished it on the ground. And Hobbs is going to pull it in and falls down on it at the 25. So the Indians will have a first down and 10 and 75 yards to go to win this football game.
That kick return team or kickoff team for Butler tonight has done an outstanding job keeping the ball away from Arrington.
First down and 10 from the 24-yard line. Perkins Fairwitz drops back. Time to throw all kinds of time. Let's it go. Pulls in. DJ Petrelli gets out of bounds after he picks up the North Hills first down at the 37-yard line. To the sidelines. Why not? A minute 15 to go. First down and 10 for the Butler 39. Again, Kasparowicz drops back to throw. Goes across field. Petrelli again pulls it in at midfield. Breaks the tackle over the 45. Knocks out of bounds in Butler territory at the 44-yard line. So the Indians first down and 10 at the Butler 44. The Indians go with double wide out. Slot man to the far side. That's Tom. Single setback. From the 44, Kasparowicz drops back. Pressure being put on. Gets the ball away over the middle. John Curran pulls in the ball at the 35-yard line. And they're going to have to hurry up, take a timeout after a 10-yard catch by John Curran.
The 35-yard line, and, you know, to have a fighting chance for Socia, you only really need to get to about the 20 to the kind of football that he knows he can.
And in this situation, 36 yards on three straight reception or completions, and he's doing a whale of a job thus far.
Petrelli is the wideout to the near sideline. Slot man is Hobbs, single setback for the Indians. Kasparowicz drops back. Butler's coming at him, gets the ball away, and it's tipped.
Oh, they were going for that screen over to Lewis, and it was all set up quite well. And Butler just got a hand on the ball. I don't know who that was.
That was Scott Barty coming up to make the tip of the ball.
Let's see if he might have a chance to tie this football game up.
Double wideouts for the Indians. Slot man on the wide side of the field. Kasparowicz drops back. He's got time. He's got time. He's looking. Scrambles away. Keeps the ball. Keeps the ball. More importantly, has time to run and get out of bounds. All the way down to the 24-yard line of the Butler Golden Tornadoes.
And Eric just bought all the time he had, and then whenever he turned the ball.
So the Indians first down and 10, ball on the 23-yard line of the Golden Tornadoes. Double wide out, slot man to the near side. Kasparowicz on the long count, drops back. He's got time to throw. Good protection. Batted away, however. The ball over the middle was intended for DJ Petrelli.
The Butler defensive line gets
the quarterback. Just put your arms up and hope you get a piece of the ball, and that's what they did. Second down and 10 now. The ball on the 23-yard line. Kasparowicz with the North Hills offense looking to go ahead in the game. Kasparowicz has time to throw. Gets the ball away. Pulled in Brian Hobbs. Clock is moving, however, and North Hills is going to call a quick timeout.
Hobbs did not get out of bounds. It was very close. It was a good tackle, but he landed just inside the sideline. So North Hills uses up another timeout. Rick, is that three? This one is just so drained.
I think so. You know what? The only thing that compares to this is the seventh game of the National League Championship Series. Be about an inch or two shy.
Ooh, that'll make it third down. And now they got to be worried about picking up the first down. It will rolling to his left.
Well, they go with the trip receivers out to the left. Single setback for Kasparowicz. Third down, 1 yard to go. Lewis goes in motion to the near side. Drop quarterback. He broke the middle. Oh, five. Goes into the end zone. North Hills touchdown. North Hills. Eric Kasparowicz goes in.
Best ever. High school game I've ever seen.
There it is, the game of the year. North Hills will win this football game, barring a disaster, with 28 seconds left to go.
Hey, I'm not rolling anything out on this game, buddy.
That's right. That's right.
Eric Kasparowicz takes his team.
He's done it tonight.
That's right.
He has. He's recovered a fumble. He's intercepted a pass. He's run for two touchdowns. He's passed for a touchdown. He is a one-man wrecking crew. The Mario Lemieux of the North Hills.
That's right.
Now, unsportsmanlike conduct against North Hills.
I just want a word real quick here from Mark Madden. Mark.
Won the game?
Yeah.
Well, I think
that's right. Well, thank you very much, Mark Madden. Well said.
That was a really good point, Mark, about the just the mental toughness, how much guts Kasparowicz has.
So the Indians now go for the point after. Snap is down. The kick is up, and it's good. No good. I'm sorry. It is wide.
Now wait a minute. It's a three-point ball game, too, and that extra point really hurts. Now, there was an unsportsmanlike conduct. It wasn't marked off on the extra point. I'm wondering, is it marked off on the kickoff, Rick?
I don't believe from where he kicked that ball that penalty was marked off, and I'm going to agree with you, Jeff. I think it is going to be marked off.
They're back, and you give them an opportunity to put up a Hail Mary pass in the end zone.
Oh, man.
Now, Eric's been kicking a lot of squibs tonight. Now, kind of easy to do that from the 40, but when you're giving up so much field position from the 25, a squibber might get him in the midfield.
Interesting, Eric. That drive only took 1 minute and 7 seconds, 76 yards. What else can you say?
I think that unsportsmanlike was probably just the jubilation of the team rushing off the sideline.
So the kick by Jared Socia, and that's a nice one, long. And it's going to drive Horowski all the way back. Takes the North Hills bounce. Horowski pulls in the ball, and he's going to get out of bounds close to the 28-yard line with 22 seconds to go in the game.
This is an unbelievable scoring display by both teams here in this game. 65 points on the board, 34-31 North Hills.
John Miller now comes in as the nickel back for North Hills as they go into the prevent.
Double wide out, first down and 10 from the 28-yard line for Butler. Drops back, trying to throw. McClellan gets the ball away, and it's pulled in. And immediately out of bounds was Horowski on the catch to the 50-yard line on a 22-yard reception.
He needs to pick one more off.
Well, we're looking at a 66-yard attempt as it stands. First down and 10 from the 50 for Butler. Single setback, double wing, wide out to the near side. McClellan drops back. Pressure being put on. Jason Brazen comes in. McClellan gets away. He's got room to run, and he's going to be knocked out of bounds at the 42-yard line. 10 seconds to go in this football game with North Hills on top, 34-31.
You drop so far back from the line of scrimmage.
Well, here is a big play. Second and one, 10 seconds to go. McClellan from the North Hills 41-yard line. Man in motion, Vardy to the near side. Back to pass. And a throw. Oh, in and out of the hands of the intended receiver. That was Morrow with the intended receiver. 3 seconds to go in the game. Come back and winning this game 34-31. Here we go. This is for the game. Everybody, including your mother, out to the near sideline. And your mom doesn't look too happy. Third and one. Back McClellan. Time to set up. Butler being put on. Joe Stern barely gets him away. Here it goes for all the marbles. And the ball is batted away. North Hills. Tremendous victory tonight over Butler. And Butler cannot believe it.
People are swarming the field now. That's got to be one of the most incredible games in North Hills history.
And I've never seen a game end this way before. I'll tell you what. It's just one of those games. And everything is being thrown down onto the field. And Butler waiting, really showing a lot of class to shake the hands of the North Hills Indians. And I'll tell you what, the field is just being massacred now by all the bystanders running out onto the field.
Kind of hard to say anything after that game. You can't add anything to it. Just an incredible football game. North Hills just came out like gangbusters in the third quarter. And did Butler let up when they were down by 12 points? No, they came back, scored two quick touchdowns. And then that final drive with only a minute 37 to work with. And Kasparowicz marches his down. Winning in for Kasparowicz to scramble in for the winning touchdown from 12 yards out. What a whale of a ball game.
I'll tell you what, North Hills now on top of the Quad North. And it was a very hard-fought victory. And you have to give this team a look at as probably one of the teams, North Hills teams, with the most character to come back in the